video is to introduce the concept of the route of administration, enteral routes of administration, to you. The first major form of enteral administration of a drug is PO. Now, usually when I ask students, what does PO mean? They all answer in unison, by mouth, which is technically correct in terms of PO meaning per aura, per orum, per oral, something like that. But in fact, what PO means is by mouth and swallowed. So enteral forms of administration refer to enteric GI tract, stomach, intestines. So PO, the nurse always watches you swallow the pill, because if you don't swallow it, that's topical administration. If you do. If you just hold a pill in your mouth somewhere, under your tongue, by your cheek, whatever, that drug is being absorbed through the mucous membranes of your mouth. PO means it goes to your stomach. And you might say, well, who cares? I mean, what does it matter as long as the drug gets into your bloodstream? Well, the reason it matters is that the veins that drain from the stomach, so if this is your stomach here and your intestines, right? So the veins that drain from your stomach and your intestines all converge into one big vein called the hepatic vein or the portal vein, and that's a vein that goes to the liver. And there's a specific reason why all the blood that comes from your GI tract first goes to the liver before it goes anywhere else, and that's to deactivate any possible toxins. Because, you know, you're walking around and it's, you know, 10,000 years ago and you're really hungry and you're like, I'll see if this is edible, and you eat it and then you're like, I wonder if this is edible. And so if you just stick random things in your mouth and swallow them, then there's a good chance something in there is going to be poisonous. So your liver has all these enzymes in it that help metabolize or biotransform or deactivate toxins so that you have some chance of surviving your foray into the forest to eat random things. Now, in terms of drugs and pharmacology, it's very important to know about the metabolism that happens within the liver. And because some drugs, when they're absorbed through the wall of the stomach, they are metabolized so extensively just by passing one time through the liver that the effective dose that you've given them is so tiny it's not going to work. You know, because you have to have a certain amount of drug in your bloodstream before it actually has a chance to work, or else it can't bind receptors and do its thing. So drugs that have what's called high first pass metabolism means that the drug is very deactivated on the first pass through the liver. Okay, that's important because if you have a drug that has high first pass metabolism, if you swallow that pill, then only a tiny percentage of it is going to get to your bloodstream. If you just hold the pill under your tongue until it all melts and is absorbed, if you absorb all of the pill that was meant to be in your stomach, then you're probably getting a way higher dose than you're supposed to, because the amount that gets to your bloodstream is going to be so much higher if that same amount of drug doesn't first go through your stomach. So I have a whole video about that first pass metabolism, which you should go to and take care of, so if you don't understand it. All right, so PO, enteral forms of administration, important because of first pass metabolism. Another important thing about PO administration is that if a drug is going to be absorbed in the stomach, the acidity within the stomach is going to have a huge impact on whether or not that drug is absorbed. So for example, if you have a weak acid molecule that is used as a drug, like aspirin. Aspirin is a weak acid. Just the molecule itself sitting in a jar in a chemistry lab. That's a weak acid. Weak acids, when they are in an acidic environment, like the acidic environment of your stomach, the pH there is about 2 or something like that. Those drugs in the low pH environment don't have any charge on them. They don't have pluses or minuses or anything like that. And so when they have no charge, that means they're called nonpolar, which means that those drugs can be absorbed or dissolved in fat, which means that those drugs can dissolve through the cell membrane of the cells of the stomach lining and then into the bloodstream. So an acidic drug is best absorbed in an acidic environment. And again, a whole other video, so go watch that video if that doesn't make sense or you need to learn about it. Okay. Now, the acidity of the stomach turns out to be really important, because if an acidic drug is really only well absorbed in an acidic environment, once it gets past the stomach, then not much of it's going to get absorbed, because in the intestines the pH is much higher, you know, it's closer to 7, pretty much the rest of your body. Your stomach is like the only place in your body where the pH is about the same as like Diet Coke or, you know, a soda, which is about 2 or something like that. So anyway, one form of drug interaction happens when something like an antacid, which specifically is designed to neutralize stomach acid in the cases of heartburn, which is a specific situation, that can really change the amount of absorption of that drug. Another thing that can change the absorption of a drug that is given PO, or enteral, by enteral administration, is the formulation of the drug. So drug formulation refers to how is that drug going to be packaged so that you can get it to a patient. So for instance, you might have something like acetaminophen, which is the common trade name is Tylenol, and it's called paracetamol in Europe and elsewhere, but it's the same molecule, which it has some uses mostly as a pain and fever reducer. And you can give a patient acetaminophen many different ways. You can give it as a pill. You can give it as a capsule full of little beads. You can crush it up and make it into a powder and sell it that way. And the idea is that you have the powder and you pour it into some water and drink it, which is horrible because Tylenol tastes awful. But, you know, if it's already dissolved, then that's going to be absorbed faster through your stomach wall than if you just put a pill in there that has to have a chance to dissolve. Other formulations of PO drugs include, you know, elixirs and syrups and, you know, all sorts of different things like that. There's all sorts of stuff to get the drug into your stomach. And the different formulation, really the only effect that's going to have for 99.999% of drugs, the only effect the formulation is going to have is on the amount and speed of absorption of the drug in the stomach and the intestines. So that's for PO drugs. There's a drug company in Canada that makes Tylenol as a powder, and again, you have to put it into water and then drink it. Tylenol tastes horrible if you've ever kept it in your mouth. And evidently the drug company's motto is, you know it must be good because it tastes so bad. And that has nothing to do with how it works. And in fact, there's been a number of studies that patients actually believe a drug works better if it tastes bad. So the reason a lot of pills taste bad is that people think a bad tasting pill works better than a good tasting pill, which of course is silly because, you know, when you have a pediatric version of a drug and it tastes like bubble gum, it works just as well as an adult, you know, the same drug would in an adult. So don't buy into that. But the Canadian company that makes the powder, one thing that particular formulation gives you the advantage of having a faster onset because the drug's already dissolved before it gets to your stomach. That brings us to another issue with PO drugs, and that has to do with generics. So a generic drug is a drug that is the same exact molecule as the trade name of the drug, just packaged in a different way. Most of the time, it doesn't matter. If generics are cheaper, definitely go with a generic. But be aware that there's lots of generic companies that make drugs. So if you get a generic pill one day of your prescription and you come back a month later and you get a generic pill, it may not be the exact same generic pill. Most of the time, it does not make any difference, and it's fine. It only rarely makes a difference if you have a drug the effect of the drug is very closely tied with only a tiny change in the amount of drug in your bloodstream. But for the most part, all generic drugs are the same. Other enteral forms of administration, there's PO by mouth and swallowed. There's using an NG tube, a nasogastric tube, where you thread a tube up through your nose and then down into your esophagus and into your stomach, usually in terms of situations where the patient is either unconscious or can't take something by mouth for whatever reason. There's also something called a peg, which is a little sort of port that's just put directly into the stomach. The point is that enteral forms of drug administration are important pharmacokinetically speaking because of the effects of different things on the absorption of that drug due to the formulation, and we talked about generics, and also first pass metabolism, because drugs that are absorbed through the GI or intestine first go to the liver before they go over anywhere else. All other forms of administration do not go to the liver first. They first just go to a vein, and then to your right heart, and then to your lungs, then your left heart, and then to the rest of your body. So that's, and some of that goes to your liver, but it's not like all of it goes to your liver. Okay. All right, so that is PO drugs. All right, so let's go in and edit this because whatever.